Aloha, welcome back. Well, rat lungworm disease has reached Hawaii, and we've already had an expert on Take Two to tell us what the disease is and how to properly wash our vegetables. But today, we're learning how to protect yourself from the potential source, your garden. Josh Silva, assistant extension agent from the University of Hawaii at Manoa, joins us this morning with gardening tips. Good morning.
Hey, good morning. Thank you for having me.
Of course. So happy to have you. So we've learned from past experts that have come in what exactly rat lungworm is, rat lungworm disease, and that it comes from snails and slugs. So you're here to tell us how to kind of prevent those from our garden. Where do we start?
So the first thing in your garden is being able to identify if you have slugs and snails present. So being able to inspect if you have leafy damage. So if you see the slug damage has eaten some of your crop. Also, we've all seen what slug slime looks like. So being able to inspect that either on top of the crop or in the surrounding areas. Mm-hmm. Also being able to identify what slug droppings look like. So they don't, they have pictures online, but being able to distinguish that between slugs versus something like a caterpillar, for example.
Okay, so the main thing for controlling is once you identify that there's a problem. And then once you've identified it, what can you do?
So there's a couple of different things you can do. So for one, you can have put up a barrier, which serves as a deterrent. So there are different products and practices that you can find on our extension website, for example, or even online. But here I brought a copper tape. So copper, from what the research tells us, is it irritates the slugs.
Oh, I've heard of this.
Yeah.
But it's actually a lot thinner than I thought.
Yeah, so you have different grades of copper. So you can have thicker bands, or you can find these kind of copper tapes with an adhesive on the back online. And how this works is, I guess I have my prop here.
Okay.
But basically, you would just take a strip, rip it off, and place it right on the edges.
So, and then this will prevent them from going into your plants.
It should. But the thing is, with this copper strip, you have to make sure a couple of things. One, you want it to be long enough, because if the slug is strong enough, as well as depending on the grade of the copper, because copper does degrade with wetness, weather, things like that, you may need to make it thicker. So we recommend about like 5 inches or 6 inches strip. So you might have to triple up on this.
Okay. So kind of how we did with the multiple layers then.
Yes.
Okay.
And also, like I said, it does degrade over time, so you may need to recharge it maybe depending once every couple weeks. Depends on your conditions. And also, once slugs get up there, their slime can also degrade it, too.
Oh, interesting. Yeah. Okay, so the copper strips and tape, a super awesome way to prevent them. What other recommendations do you have?
So if, like we said, the barrier just serves as the deterrent. It doesn't control the population. So another thing you can do is either put traps. So here I brought example of boards. So slugs, they like two things. They like darkness and they like moisture. So that's why we typically see slugs going out at night for foraging their food.
Mm-hmm.
But we also want to, when we said we want to identify slugs, when we inspect them, we search for these hiding spots. So one, if you have a garden area and say, for example, you have, you know, old pots lying around, or if you have buckets or even pieces of board, look under them. To see if you find slugs there. But you can also make your own and put them in the area where you can, in the late afternoon, you would water it very deeply to attract the slugs. Then you'd put your trap, whether it's a board like this with a gap,
okay,
or you could put a pot, an old pot, put it under there. And in the either nighttime or early morning hours, you can come and inspect it and you'd physically remove them.
Okay.
But for the physical removal, you want to make sure a couple of things. So one, use your gloves. So make sure you don't get any of the slug slime or parts on top of you, as well as if you need, wear safety goggles or glasses. And if you are, say for example, these little twigs are our slugs and I come in the morning inspect it, you can either use your hands if you have gloves, or if you have a tong, you can use a tong, or if you have some of our senior citizens who may have this extendable reacher grabber, you can also use that to pick it up.
Perfect.
So when you pick it up, we recommend putting them in what people in the biz call the slug jug, or if you have a other way, you can have it a snail pail.
So cute.
But you'd grab your slug with the tongs and just place it in there. So this slug jug is has one part salt and 7 parts water.
Oh, and you know how snails and slugs react to salt.
Yeah.
Okay.
So and you would just leave them in there for a couple of days, and once you fill it up, or you know you don't want to deal with it anymore, you can dispose of it in the trash, or If you want, you can dig a deep enough hole and bury it, but you know, we find that the trash is easier to dispose of.
Yeah, if you did rebury them, is that kind of using it as almost a compost, or is that
something like that,
at all? Okay.
Yeah.
A little bit. Okay. So very cool. Okay, so one part salt, one part water, and then you
or
can
seven
just
parts water.
Oh, sorry. What is that?
Oh, one part salt and seven parts.
Seven
water.
Parts yeah. water. Okay. Awesome. And then that will do the trick.
Yes.
Okay. So there's a lot more water then. Mm-hmm. Okay. So good to know. And when you were saying traps, you actually don't have to go out and buy your own traps. It's usually things that you already have.
Yeah.
You just kind of have
so
to.
So using your hiding
them.
Spots, or maybe situating someplace else where it's away from your crops.
Okay, very yeah. cool. And again, this is where a lot of this disease can originate from, again, the slugs and the snails mm-hmm. and in your garden. But also, again, be sure to always be washing your vegetables properly before you consume them, especially if you're not cooking them.
Yes.
Awesome. Thanks so much for these great tips. So happy to have you.
Yeah, thank you.
All right. Well, again, make sure you're practicing your safety when it comes to your garden and also your garden health.